Hello, you multi Mixolydian melodies. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And thank you to Lord Rupley in Sydney, Australia, for that malt mention. Introducing Whiskey Review 319. And just a quick reminder, Whiskey Review 318 is about cognac. This one's about cognac. 320 will be about Armagnac. And 321 will also be about Armagnac. And none of them are Scotch whiskies. Because, my merry maltsters, we embrace and we enjoy variety. We learn from Scotch whiskey and we take what we've learned from Scotch whiskey and we go all around the world and we travel far and wide and we discover one of the great spirity truths, and that is that there are three other spirits out there that have tremendous diversity and character like Scotch whisky: rum, tequila mezcal, and cognac Armagnac. But there are also other exciting, interesting spirits around the world we have yet to come across, because they're not available yet, but mark my words, they will be. Whether it be aged Polish vodka, whether it be bitter German schnapps, whether it be cashew spirit from India, fascinating stuff. Look forward to trying that. With this video review, this vlog, as we call it, video blog, vlog, we are sharing an adventure with a particularly interesting cognac. Very different from my last review, which was of a cognac, as you can see up in the Bothy library shelves there. Yes. Maxime Trillol, very cognac looking, that's the way it's been packaged. It's generally available. If it's not available, you'll find similar variations of this theme with Hein and Hennessy and Remy Martin, although I quite like that one. But as a seasoned Scotch whisky punter, I think this will be very interesting to share with you. Now, just you settle down, pour yourself a glass, have your water jug ready. I'll give you a minute or two just to settle yourselves down. Yes, yeah. Just obey the three golden rules of enjoying your whiskey or any other quality spirit. Make sure it's quality, take your time with it, and don't get rat-arsed. Yes, because it would upset me if I heard through the grapevine and Twitter and Facebook that you were 3 o'clock in the morning tripping over drunk and lying in the carpet in your own warming pish. That would upset me. It would. I don't like to think people are doing that. Invariably, it concludes in liver disease and other problems. So take your time. Keep it quality. This is the other side of Maxime Trillol, which, as you can see, has been super branded. Much plainer bottle, practical label here. This is an independent bottling of a small house cognac, en petite maison. C'est le maison Gruber. Gruber, which is a little family-run cognac distillery in the Grand Champagne region of Cognac, just about south of Cognac Town, the town of Cognac, which gives its name to the spirit. And not a big volume production. And my guess is, even before I bought this, that I would be getting a cognac with challenging personality. And it's very much the case. I'm going to give you my tasting notes now. This is enhanced by the fact that it's bottled at cask strength of 57.9%. And because I have been using my rather steampunk and trusty magnifying glass, I can tell that it is individual cask. This is single cask cognac of 426 bottles. So a large cask. to get that number of bottles out at cask strength, you're talking a big cask, so you're talking less spirit to wood contact, therefore a younger flavour for its age, but possibly more depth as well. Let's see how we get on. Nose. Immediately I'm sensing the depth. There's an almost a deep treacle hint to the raisin sweetness that's arriving in the nose. Very toffee, natural toffee. Wood bitters as well. Lapsang Souchong tea, that's that very bitter, astringent tea that you get, quite aromatic, distinctive. Try it, buy it and try it, malt mates. Lapsang Souchong, very interesting experience. Cola, melon, old oak, slight musty, dusty, leathery note there. Almost a kind of Oloroso sherry, but dry. Rose water, gentian, Dijon mustard, there's a wee mustardy French grain mustard note. Avocado, so we've got vegetable, a vegetal presence there. And it's pretty intense, neat. Tasting it neat. Oh, it really digs in. Bitter. Almost harsh flavour. If you were to drink this neat, your first impressions would not be positive. You'd say it was over-oaked. Now, that's what your big mistake would be, judging on first impressions. I've mentioned this previously. Too many people rush the drink, what they're drinking. They'll concentrate on the first couple of minutes and then get distracted by something else and then just knock back the contents after 5, 10, 15 minutes and then the event's over. 1, 2, 3. When you add a drop of water to bring this down, the nose becomes softer, there's a sappiness creeps in and the bitter notes settle down, because what's happening is the sweetness from the wood, which is nowhere to be seen in its raw state, undiluted state, it comes forward after 15 minutes. This cognac is spectacularly, and there's no other way of putting it, spectacularly transformed from a very belligerent quality spirit to something far more sublime. So just imagine, we're moving on 15 minutes later. I've poured 3 teaspoons of water into that glass. I've gone and put a lid on it to keep the smells from wafting away. I want to keep them contained so I can get, so my nose gets the benefit of the smells. And 15 minutes later, I come back to this. A rich honeyed toffee note. More rose water, Turkish delight even, mild mustard. Far less stringency and bitterness in the nose. It's rare that I've come across any spirit that has evolved so much, so quickly in the glass as this cognac. Taste. The intense raisined figginess and the integration with the harsher wood elements is changing because the wood's toning down. There's a sweetness coming through. It's kind of pushing away the bitterness and the harshness of the wood significantly. There's a delicate but substantial floral note coming through. We're talking heavily scented summer flowers that you'd have in a vase that would fill the room with their bouquet, that sort of smell. It's various. It's not one single flower stands out. It's a complex, integrated floral of many kind of different floral individual notes. Papaya, guava, eau de cologne, walnut. There's a delightful nuttiness. Again, this is just the way this has changed over 15 minutes with some water in it. A beautiful natural nuttiness is coming to the surface, walnuts in particular. Dry, but sweet, bittersweet, dry sweet, sour sweet. A very busy, complex, top quality spirit experience by any standard. Whereas I described the Maxime Triol as an engineered cognac, sweet from start to finish, interesting, engaging, but very much tailored for preconceived market expectations. We've got the opposite here, a totally natural presentation, simple bottle, simple label from an old-fashioned, old-school, independent bottler, Cadenheads. And if you're looking for another whiskey independent bottler that does cognac, you're also looking then at Berry Brothers and Rudd in London. They've got some good stuff. But taste-wise, the complexity, the fruit, the earthiness that comes through as well is absolutely exquisite. There's almost a fresh soil note. Quite a cool, fresh soil note in with the fruit and the floral and that nuttiness. It's not just walnut, there's almond, bitter marzipan, bitter almonds. The balance between the bitter and sweet is wonderful. Simply not a spirit you would give to beginners. It would be unrewarding, frustrating and intimidating to someone who basically is happy and content with your basic brands. But for someone who's looking for a different experience, this is the sort of stuff you want to look out for. And it's not too expensive either. This is basically a treasure hunt that's ended with some treasure, and it's the coordinates, the map readings that I saw, the small Maison Guerbet, just checking it online, having a look at their own website, saying, right, we've got an independent bottling of an old school family owned cognac house that's not well known, it's not out there, it's not a big brand. And that is where the excitement really kicked in. And it wasn't till I'd bought this I discovered it was a single cask cognac. And I must say, 8 years old, by the way, this is XO Plus. That's what this is, 8 years. And it's not too old, you know, this freshness of the grape, of the... not quite sure which variety it would be. I think it would be Uigny Blanc would be the variety used. It's just reeking of terroir and authenticity. And I'm giving it 91 out of 100. And that is a Brandy Cognac Armagnac mark. I feel I'm probably being a bit mean. In fact, yeah. Forget what I just gave this. That's better. Any more comments? Needs the water. Without the water, you're just not going to get it. 10% mint, at least, of water. Even now, there's a fresh melon note coming through as it continues to evolve. Authentic stuff. The transition from a rough, woody first impression to the most delightful, balanced, complex, full-flavoured, real-deal cognac is quite simply wonderful. And for me, a cynical old whiskey hack, this has in fact been a delightful treat. There we have it. Hope you've enjoyed this cognac review. We'll be moving on to whiskey review 319 shortly. I hope you'll want to join me as we discuss this bottle of Armagnac that's sitting in the shelf right behind me going, Ralphie, Ralph me, pour a glass, enjoy me, enjoy me. All in good time, Armagnac, all in good time.